We just completed chapter 3 in the last video. This one we will be progressing forward with preparations to enter chapter 4. So we'll get started here. Heading up the stairs for a cutscene. Messenger bird injured. What is it going to tell us?
Basil.
All right, so we have our new objective. We need to go to the crippled Burrick. See what's up with our friend Basso. All right, if you've been following along with us, you'll know this is pretty much speed run, because what we're trying to do is get the trophy for completing the game with a custom difficulty level of at least 700. We've been playing through on a custom difficulty with 735, and we will continue to do so all the way to the end of the game to get that trophy. Nothing's changed. We don't have anything to worry about up here, so again, we continue just to dash across the roof.
We'll show those tallow black tar.
Then we head into the crippled Burrick. Yes, we would like to enter, so we can continue to move along in the game while Razz shows us how to get the Platinum Trophy. Wait for this to finish loading up. This guy again.
Where's Basso? The thief taker general dragged him off along with some of my graven. He's taken it. I should have known the Baron would do this.
You're telling me my friend's been beaten and dragged all because of that book?
What's so important? There is the key to saving this city, saving all of us from the gloom. And yet I know the Baron would not use it for such good. And now he has it! Basso knew that book was important.
Lucky for you, it's still here then. Basso's no idiot.
Book.
Sounds like a good read. Where'd they take Basso?
To the keep, but it's well guarded. You can't just walk in the door.
That's good.
Loyal, devoted to the cause, wanted to strike the Baron in his heart, so he's been studying the keep for some time. He knows a way in.
my fence. I'll see about your graven.
We're not so different, you and I. Garrett. You change. One day the people will think of you. You think too much of the people. Let's see if Orion's man, Jacob, knows anything. I'll find him at Greystone Plaza.
Alright, so we have our objective. We need to go to Greystone Plaza, as our friend Basso has been kidnapped. Before we go there, you want to come up here?
I have something for all your nefarious needs.
To the merchant. Want to make sure. So we have three. We need one in this playthrough. We have two poppies. We can go ahead and sell them. With them we don't need, can't use. The razor don't need in during this playthrough. We do need the wire cutters. There's an optional way we can go in chapter 4 that uses it. Takes us a little bit longer, but it stays 100% ghost. Also we'll be needing it later chapters for traps, disarming traps and things. So we have the money, so we'll go ahead and buy it now. And no trinkets at this time. Alright, so let's head back the other way. We're going out the other door than we did the first time. Avoid those two guards who are walking over there. There's two more over here. Aim was off a little bit. And we can climb up over here just to get off the street. We can grab this coin purse right here that the birds had and use this passageway right here to come around to where we need to go without arousing any suspicion. And like always in these things, hold down square button to get through. All right, now you're in a new section here. And you can see where we need to go, that direction. Guards can't see us anyways, but
I don't know.
Baron's machines will be destroyed, and when the smoke clears, the dawn will break. We'll breathe freely again out of the stink of Cinderfall. Fresh food and water for all, and faith in a better future. But first, we must prove ourselves.
You can See all the different gates. Okay, chapter 4, A Friend in Need.
Now to see Jacob.
All right, so there we are. We're now in chapter 4, A Friend in Need.
There's a lot of panicking people in Greystone Plaza. I'm guessing it's too late to get anything from Jacob. But I am close to Eastwood's Hills, Baron's architect. If anyone knows back door into the keep, it will be the man who built it.
Okay, up we go. We go. We're down we go. And then just follow around here. Alright, so you can. So we have a. There's another passage on the other side here, but. Jump across. There you go, brief little cutscene right there.
For Basso's sake, I hope the keep is built as strong as they say.
All right, and squeeze through the crates. Then we'll be at the architect's house.
Eastwick City House. No one ever called his work subtle. Seems I'm not the only one making a house call tonight.
Okay, so we got a new objective. This is really the point where our story starts for chapter 4, so we'll... going here. Gotta watch out for these two guards right here.
Rourke's teeth.
Okay, down we go again. Dog right there.
Eastwick City House. No one ever called his work subtle. Seems I'm not the only one making a house call tonight.
All right, boy. Remember, Eastwick built this place himself. Hidden passages, machinery in the walls, a real house of tricks. He's shut himself up in his study room, but watch for heels in the night. I don't want him escaping.
Sir, isn't Eastwick the architect of the Baron himself?
Aye. Not to leave the premises without the Baron's escort.
All right, so there we go.
Up the ladder. And then get back down in your crouch position. All right, and in we go.
Eastwick's locked himself up in his own study. Huh.
If I'm not careful. It's absurd, Tilly. The Baron's men come to hood
we can
and
drop
onto her as if he was a common
case
thief.
Right here.
I'm sure it's
being
a misunderstanding.
Undetected.
Oh, they have their orders. That's
all right, so let's do a save right here.
They said, orders, ma'am. I told them orders won't get him out of his study.
He has been up there for some time now. 3 nights.
Up the door
more.
To your left. Close the
Here
door.
We make to leave this squalid city.
All right, now we have another door. Saw a guard over there, but
what?
Should be good to get into the library from here.
You're saying there's a hidden entrance in here somewhere?
I said I've often seen the master enter here, but found it empty when I check upon him.
You haven't ever nosed about for it?
No, course not. It wouldn't be my place.
Okay, so let's make another save.
Come on, Mother Mulberry. You're talking noble, but you aren't noble.
When you're quite finished, I have packing up to do.
All right, all right. Back to it. Check the room myself.
Climb the desk.
An entrance. Just what I'm looking for.
Climb the bookshelves.
I think a tooth's coming loose. Your master Eastwick is definitely hiding
something. All right, you see the glass.
Locked in his room like that and not coming out.
So you gotta be careful.
I don't know what he's thinking, refusing the watch at a time like this. Hey, I think I saw someone.
I saw someone! Help! Guards!
They saw us.
Finally, some action, eh? Hold where you are!
That's why we loaded right there. It's a little tricky to get across the glass. But you saw there on the right, the bookcase has the secret entrance we need to pop. Go again.
friggin' bastard. Well, halt where you are!
Size before we got it turned. A little trouble with this one. Let's be better this next time. Still, she sees us too quickly, so. Man. Sorry about that, guys.
To push around, then. That's too bad.
Should be get through without any trouble there. Alright, so there's a ghost way you can go. We can go through the basement and use the wire cutters, avoiding all that trouble that we just went through, but the suspicion won't fail any of our trophies. The up button on the elevator. There we go. This will take you to the rooftop. See, we're getting closer to the marker. And we triggered a new one.
What's Eastwick been doing up here? Admiring the view of his collapsing monuments? Well, I can't leave him alone with his thoughts. I need those plans.
Finally, the gate opened. And I come down here, and this button's okay to push. It is not a button for the light.
That explains his lack of cooperation. First Cornelius, now Eastwick. Being one of the Baron's associates appears to be bad for your health. One way or another, he was going to swing.
Climb this ladder here to the left. Don't worry about any noise you hear and ruckus. We're going to be fine until we get to our objective.
Elias Northcrest, you are to present yourself to his watch.
All the way around to here. Two switches on this diagram. Okay, so
that's my interest in this expensive toy set.
What we need to do is turn and rotate this building so that matches the one in the window over there.
Release this door!
Arrange the model to match the building before the building comes down.
Is he playing at Rat Sally Jack in there or what?
Okay, So once you take the plans right here, and you can see the safe code for later, 301198. Then we'll be in a pursuit in this chapter. So until then, you're free to pretty much do whatever you want in here. For us, we will take it, and we will fire up the cutscene. So we already have the sprint trigger and the toggle set up, so we should be moving right off the top. Don't go up the stairs, go straight ahead. Right. Jump off the end for a cutscene.
Let's see. This opening at the base, some sort of steam vent or exhaust shaft. It would be suicide to break in through there. That should buy me back the element of surprise.
And what's this?
The Baron's great safe. Rumored to be the size of a house and filled with gold. Rumored.
All right. Nothing to worry about in here. This is a safe area. Make your way to the rope. Climb the rope up. Jump off to the balcony. So you can look around here and see this passageway right here. Right before you go that little passageway, grab the water arrow right here, and then drop down. And here we go through. Pretty linear path right here. You kind of only have one way to go. We're coming up to a real hazardous area. that we're going to be struggling with. Here we go with the new area. Keep waterfront. To watch out for the fires and for any enemies. You can see some ahead of us, some guards. Gotta be super careful where we walk. Get in here. There's gonna be some stairs going down. Here we go, down the stairs. Fire off. Grab the poppy. Swoop into the next room. Alrighty. Now here we are. Okay, there's no enemies, but there's some hazards. Get up on the ladder, and we can continue to move forward. So we have to watch out for these flames. Swoop. Out for that piston right there. So here we are, we're in the engine level now.
Drop. Shit, that valve's blown.
gotta be fast about picking these locks. We're running out of time, we're dying. You can see there on the left, bottom left. Died just as we got through. Alright, but that's the path. You want to be quick about it.
Raven attack has shaken the keep to its core. Still, it's a way in. Now to find the prison where they're holding Basil.
Fire. Come on, fire. Alright. Fire didn't give us a break right there. Drop down. And we're safe from the gas. Once you drop down there, then you should be good. Lock to pick. To the prison level. Push the button, call the elevator. There it is. So we gotta wait for this elevator ride, and then we'll be able to rescue our friend Basil. Here, fire up the lever. And here we are. We've rescued him.
Thanks, Garrett. Going a little crazy in there. I even wished I had Genevieve with me. That scum-sucking bastard. I always thought if anyone was gonna kill her, it'd be me. What are you up to? Oh, wait. You're not thinking about those tall tales about the legendary Great Safe, are you? Look, Garrett. No one is paying you to risk your neck for this. It's not about the payment.
Nope, but we will go anyways.
Garrett, if you get out of here alive, I mean, you know, when you get out of here, be at the Siren's Rest in the southern quarter.
All right, so Basco is rescued, and we have a new objective, find the Great Safe. Can we take this elevator ride to the top? And then we'll try and break into the Great Safe. Yep, it's a long ride up. Get there. Almost there.
Baron's vision of order and efficiency. If he truly understood this city, he'd know it would never survive here.
There we are. And you gotta climb out the top. Here we go. Out this exit and squish down and then here we go. There it is. There's nobody in here
yet.
This might
be a really bad idea.
Grab the ladder. Lever? Ladder. Here comes this safe. So now we have to run around to both sides to click the buttons to open the safe. So you got to see, you're going to see we're going to have to do some running from one side to the other here. So just give me a layout of the plan of where it is. All right, so there's a button here and then one on the other side. Push it, run to the other side. And push it.
Eastwick must have the original code.
All right, if you remember the code from before, 301198. It's the first digit of each of the three combinations, so the 3 of 30 and the 1 of 11 and the 9 of 98 are what these are. Okay, so that one's done. Now we gotta do this one. Uh-oh. Trouble.
Didn't you know, Garrett? Greed is a sin. And you must be punished for your sins. But I understand greed, my friend. Where it comes from. You made it so easy. All I had to do was get you in the building. You see, I know you better than you know yourself. You'll swing from a noose in the morning. Master thief. Guards! Seize that overgrown rat!
Let's ride this safe up. much they can do about it.
Maybe Basil was right. It better be the trickster's own gold teeth in the jar inside this thing.
Fast this off.
Maybe Basil was right. Better be the trickster's own gold teeth in a jar inside this thing.
There's nowhere else for the flagon to go, and he's hurt. He must have come up here.
So hide here in this corner.
Harry freaking Mills.
Swoop a couple times. Then enter your zero. Fire off the cutscene. Steal the primordial stone. And we're almost done with this level. Want to follow along here, grab these poppies as you go. Obviously we can't use them, you know this already, but to progress this forward, that's what we got to do.
You filthy children will do as I say, or you'll feel the sting of my whip. Come here,
forward
boy.
Here, and we will come across Aaron again. We just have to
there's
follow
pain
her.
Here I'm screaming. The sick and the dying, I can't block it out anymore. It hurts, Garrett. But underneath all the noise lie the whispers. Follow me, Garrett, and I'll tell you a secret.
There she is again.
You grow up strong when you grow up alone. There's no one to help you up.
No one to hold you back.
Is that why you let me go, Garrett? Because I was the only family you had? We never did see eye to eye. Big brother always knows best.
I tried to help, but you wouldn't listen.
You know, I was just thinking the same thing about you. I'm going to make them stop. I want to sleep like you did. Northcrest. He's here.
So just keep following me, even though we don't see her anymore.
You want to know what happened? Where you've been? Come to the asylum. Moira harbors truths others would sooner forget.
Up till you get to this barred door.
You're here to save me? then you'll need a key. Look behind you.
Okay,
just
turn.
Steal it. You've never hesitated before.
Grab the object. We'll have a couple more cutscenes.
That didn't quite go according to plan, but at least I'm alive. I need to get back to the clock tower and clear my head.
There we go, chapter 4 completed, a friend in need. Mostly his opportunist. And there's the trophy. All right, there we are. 6 nights later, we're back to full health. We've completed chapter 4. So remember to like our videos. I'm going to end this one here. We're going to meet Basso now that we've rescued him. Friend and like us on Twitch. Subscribe on YouTube. And we will see you next time. Thank you again for following along with us. Much appreciated.